And we love our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for so many reasons. We love him because of what he came with. We love him because Allah chose him. We love him because the Quran came down to him. And most importantly, we love him because he embodied the perfection of humanity, the noble characteristics, the best embodiment of being a good human being is our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As Allah says in the Quran, wa innaka la ala khuluqin azim. Your manners are the best manners, the most perfect manners are the manners of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And of course we love him and we want the world to love him, but there have always been people who opposed him. There have always been people who mocked and ridiculed him for whatever reason. They didn't want to give up their status, they didn't want to give up their powers, they didn't want to give up their false gods. Whatever reason, there were people that opposed him. And in his lifetime, he showed us how to deal with his opponents and how to deal with those who mocked and ridiculed him. The seerah is full of such incidents. The Quran is full of so many verses that especially the Meccan surahs, and we'll get to the Madani surahs in a while, especially in the Meccan surahs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, turn away from the ignorant who make fun of you. Allah says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, regarding those who mock him, فَصْفَحْ الصَّفْحَ الْجَمِيلِ, go ahead and overlook a beautiful overlooking. Don't stoop to their level. Allah says, return harshness with good, and you will find the one who hates you will in fact end up loving you. All of these are explicit Quranic verses. And one of the most important stories of the seerah that we teach our children, a story that we grow up hearing the details of over and over and over again, is the incident of Ta'if. The incident of Ta'if, when our Prophet ﷺ was bloodied, when his shoes were soaking with his own blood, when he had no protector other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah then sent him all of the forces of this world. He handed over the angel of the mountains and said, do as you please, that you have every right to destroy them. And what did our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do? What did he do? We all know this story. He said no, and he had every right to destroy them. Wallahi, if any group deserved to be killed and eliminated, it is that group. But what did our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? No, maybe their children will become worshippers of Allah. He was merciful to them, thinking of the future. And imagine now, Ta'if, as we know, is a major city of Islam. Our mother Aisha narrates that in Medina, our Prophet was sitting when a group of evil people came in, and they were munafiqun and some of the Yahud who rejected Islam, and they mocked the Prophet. They would say things and wink. And one of the things they would love to say is, Assalamu alaykum, without the lam. Assam in Arabic means the plague, disease, death. Assalamu alaikum, not assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. And they would wink at one another, look what we're saying. And so it means, may you be destroyed, may the plague come upon you. And the Prophet ﷺ said, wa alaikum. And Aisha was behind the curtain. And more people came, and the winking is going on, and she could not bear it anymore. From behind the curtain, her voice came out. And she said, wa alaikum assalam, wa ghadabullahi wa la'natuh. May Allah's curse and la'na and the plague be on you. How dare you say this to the Prophet ﷺ? The people were shocked and they left in their haste. Our Prophet ﷺ said to Aisha, O Aisha, have you ever seen me be vulgar? Have you ever seen me be vulgar? He chastised Aisha. Why did you speak like this to those people? And Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, didn't you hear what they said? Didn't you hear they're making fun of you? They're not saying assalamu alaikum. And of course the Prophet ﷺ knew. And he said, O Aisha, didn't you hear my response? Wa alaikum, and upon you as well. You wish me the death, I wish you as well. Let's see whom Allah will give it to. You made dua. You said it back in a beautiful manner. In a beautiful manner. And you leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the incidents go on and on and on. And yes, it is true, and we are not denying that there are incidents in the seerah, just a handful, just a few, where some people combined their rejection of Islam with also being a political threat, with also doing things that will be harmful to the state. So their ridicule was not just ridicule personally to the Prophet. It also represented a strategic threat. For these people, there is no denying that some incidents of the seerah demonstrate that the law was handed to them. And yes, they were punished for what they had done. And nobody is denying this. But the fact of the matter is that the general rule that our Prophet demonstrated throughout his life was the rule of mercy. The fact of the matter, the hadith hadith is in Bukhari. Our mother Aisha says, memorize this hadith, brothers and sisters. Those who think they know the Sharia without even having read a single book of fiqh or a single book of hadith, memorize what our mother Aisha says as reported in the most authentic book. She says, wallahi, the Prophet ﷺ never took revenge for anything because of a personal issue. مَنْ تَقَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لِنَفْسِهِ قَطْ. Never did he take revenge for anything for a personal reason, except if it was something for the sake of Allah, for religion, yes, but not for himself. And so where then do we begin when it comes to describing the one whom Allah has chosen above the entire creation? How can we do justice to him when Allah Azza wa Jal himself says, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Allah says, we have raised up your mentioning and remembrance. Allah has raised up his mentioning and remembrance. And Ibn Abbas and other scholars of the Sahaba, they said, Allah has raised up his remembrance such that whenever Allah is mentioned, the Prophet ﷺ is mentioned right after that. And how true this is. Whenever Allah is mentioned, the Prophet ﷺ is almost always mentioned right after that. Even in our Shahada, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. In the Adhan, in the Salah that we pray, in the Qur'an itself, there's hardly a khutbah that we give, except that we praise Allah and we send salat and salam upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself has called our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَرَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. You are the mercy to the entire world. You are the embodiment of rahmah. Allah has sent you, and through you, you will be given rahmah. And you are a rahmah. And you are the channel of Allah's rahmah. So he is rahmah. The Prophet is rahmah. And his sending is rahmah. And his message is rahmah. And his teachings is rahmah. And believing and acting upon what he has come with is a rahmah. He is everything associated with mercy. That is rahmatan lil alameen. So how then can we begin to do justice to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when Allah has praised him so highly? Allah has praised him. And the angels have praised him. And the people on earth have praised him. And all the prophets have praised him. And every single one of mankind praises him directly or indirectly. And therefore, the Prophet ﷺ is praised in the heavens and in the earth. He is praised in the previous umam and in the present umam. He is praised in this dunya and in the akhirah. This is the ultimate praise. There is no human being who has ever been praised or is praised at this point in time or who shall continue to be praised more than our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And think about it. No millisecond occurs on this earth except that there are not millions, not tens of millions, hundreds of millions of people around the globe praising this one person sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, either by sending durood and salat and salam, or by giving a khutbah or lecture, or by giving saying the salah, because you cannot pray any salah, you cannot pray any rak'ah, except that what do you do in that rak'ah? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Think about it. There is no second on earth that goes by, except that hundreds of millions of people are praising this one human being. There is no person who is more praised than our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Our Prophet ﷺ showed us the best way to defend his honor is to follow his sunnah. And we follow his sunnah by demonstrating his character. And what was his character? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He was رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. So when we embody that, and when people see the rahmah in our lives, when they see how good we are, how kind we are, how loving we are, how peaceful we are, wallahi, this is the way to defend the honor of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the true followers of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Barakallahu wa lakum fir'an al-azim.